As I was telling y'all about the matchboxes, this is a red ball matchbox. The other one widely used is a Victorian matchbox. These are most common ways of transporting drugs in the area, selling them in the area. This is one of the gentlemen who ran to the courtyard before the units can get in here. one piece of crack was found in this matchbox, and the only problem is they can't place the drugs with the perpetrator. Since you can't place the drugs with the perpetrator, he'll be checked for warrants. If no warrants are on him, we're going to have to release him on the scene. Officer Marquez showed me that there are several other pieces of crack found in the exact same area that has been thrown to the ground by one of the would-be dealers or sellers out here.
Okay, let me see the matchbox now. Tilt it down so I can see what's inside. That's it. That's the side. I guess I still can't see it. There you go. That's great, man. Thank you.
Okay, as I was saying, after warrants check on his name, if nothing comes up on it, he's going to be released on the scene. There were approximately 10 to 15 black males in this portion of the courtyard. When the units came through, they all dispersed and ran in different directions. In the same area, this is where the drugs were found, laid out. Most of them were thrown down. Like I was saying, this is one of the most common ways of transporting drugs in the area, especially back here where it's kind of easier to get to, and if you walk around, you might see matchboxes lying on the ground and might have a good chance of finding crack inside any of them.
Huh?
You have an ID on it?
No, sir. M-E-R-C-A-D-E-L.
Mercadal? Yes, sir.
Manual. I was on the walk.
Date of birth?
The 9th of
1567. You know your social security number?
Yes, sir.
Who did it?
4911-1167.
You ever been arrested?
Yes, sir.
Before?
Possession of
what?
A guy was in a stolen car on the ground.
You was arrested? What happened to the charges?
He's still on the court.
What else you was arrested for? That was your only charge?
That was that single charge
that you were arrested once before?
No, I was only arrested one time.
No, I only been arrested one time.
Yes, 49.
What was that, sir? Last month?
Yes, sir.
What do you live? Stand up, sir.
49,
349. What do you live? Turn around.
39,
3809 Jim McGill?
3908.
Do you want you? What do you want,
sir? I'm going to talk to
the police came for you, saw the activity, didn't everybody just decided to go with their own way, right?
It started running. I was just
with 39.
Do you have a narcotics arrest? We'll find out.
Only one
narcotics arrest, right?
Not, they had a possession in the car.
Absolutely, but that's one narcotics arrest, right? You know, we know the game. That's why we wear the tan. You know, we know what's going on. Put your hand up. Keep it to yourself.
49
unit. Creature,
Raven, this flag. Could you check a name for me?
You live alone with your mother, your parents, or your wife, or what? Your mother, how old are you? 20 years of age.
21.
You're a high school graduate?
Yes.
What high school?
Yeah.
What high school?
And I went to San Francisco State University.
You went there for what, a semester?
Yes, a semester.
You get high?
No, sir.
You don't smoke?
No, sir.
You don't drink?
No.
Why you just hang out?
I don't hang out. I was on the walk and I seen.
Why you didn't complete your education?
Huh?
Why haven't you completed your education?
Because I've been working for this guy and girl for about 9 or 8 years. He took me on and said, I was really
young. Why are you hanging in drug alley?
I wasn't hanging, I was on the walking path or something. I was coming from here.
Coming from where?
Where you coming?
Okay, where were you coming from?
I was going to visit, coming to visit my cousin, just coming from the camp.
And you live on Germanville, which is practically the other side of the project. And you know what's going on over here?
You know, like I said, I don't know what's happening over there on this place.
You're a resident of the San Bernard Housing Project?
Yes, sir.
For how many years? All your life, and you don't know what's going on, what activity is going on around here?
I didn't know it was going on with, you know, right in this area. I know it's all over here.
What?
How old is
he? 20 years of age. One prior, 966, April. No, May. Here we go.
Come on,
step. Watch your step.
If you can catch a picture of the sign down there.
I don't. Not, you know, I don't have to be with y'all all the time. What does that say?
What do I prefer?
No, roll my window down, that's why I rolled
right.
Down. That up. There were three guys standing right there. They're gone now.
The residents are hooking this up?
Yes, and one person in particular, I can't recall, he changed his name.
Jakali.
Mm-hmm. You go ahead on.
His name is Edwin?
His real name is Michael Williams. I think they're going Edwin Jakali.
Edwin Jakali, that's the name he's going by now. He started the drug free zone back in the San Bernardino Housing Project. And it
go ahead, Paul.
Has become one of the most highly publicized areas in the city right now as a drug free zone.
10-4.
I think this is the first one ever started.
See if this is
and
continuous
from what he's doing with
10-7.
It has stop the drugs in the area. It gives the kids now can roam through here freely without worry of being shot, stabbed, or run over by a dealer or somebody being shot at. Now they can come and play in the courtyard like they used to do. That building, which was off to the side, was their main office, and they've taken control of the entire Floyd Court and Duplessis area. Mr. Jakali himself, who's in here every day and he's dealing with the people in the project every day, he probably knows what's going on better in this project than anybody else. He runs the drug dealers away.
649 to 604.
That's where they are. One of the main, should I say, selling of their wares, gestures are they stand on the corner. They will flag you down. They will run up to your car when one deal you supposedly have made one deal. Another guy will come up to your car and show you his wares, you know, or his crack, whether it's larger than what he's about to buy.